Hello and welcome. I'm really excited to be here planning your trip with you. For a lot of people, this is a once-in-a-lifetime experience. And we like to consider each visit that you decide to make at Jurassic World a once-in-a-lifetime experience, since we're constantly in development of new dinosaur genomes to hatch and release into the park, and also developing tons of new fun attractions that you're going to want to continue to come and visit again and again and again. Okay? So, let me start by just getting some basic information from you. I'm going to create a new file here for your trip. Okay, so can I get the names of everyone that's going to be joining you on this journey? Okay. Okay. And is that what they see or a K? Can I get your address? I'll only need yours for this right now. Okay. And that's spelled E-U-C-L-I-D. Okay, perfect. And that's it. And what's the zip code there? Perfect. And let me get your birthday. Perfect. And I'll also need an emergency contact. Someone that's not going to be joining you on this trip. All right. And what relation is that to you? Your uncle. And if I can get his phone number. Okay. Five, six. Perfect. And then, do you have the passports of all the travelers that'll be joining you? Great, I'm glad you got that email that I sent you. If I can just get them, I'll write down all the information that needs to be put in here for this initial visit. Okay? Okay. Okay, so I'm just going to check. Everyone is going to have a valid passport when you go on your trip. And I could just also verify all the spellings and the birth date. I'm gonna put down everyone's passport number. Okay. Now, if you don't mind, I'm going to make some photocopies of these passports and I'll give them back to you at the end, alright? Okay, so that's all the basic information that we need. I also need to know what kind of budget that we're looking at for the trip per person will go by. Alright. That gives me a lot of room to book in some really amazing excursions for you guys. That is just fantastic. And thankfully, this budget is also going to include airfare because I'm going to take care of that for you as well. And you don't need to worry about any extra fees or anything. What I tell you is how much it's going to cost, without any additional fees or taxes at the end there. Alright, and so when do you guys want to visit? I would say generally from December to April is our most popular time. That's when Costa Rica is having a dry season and you won't have to worry about any nasty weather sort of dampening your experience. However, it is less crowded from May to November, but I do like to inform you that some of your excursions may end up canceled because of bad weather. We can get some pretty strong storms during those months, and there's a possibility you may have to go into emergency shelter procedures during those very strong tropical storms and potential hurricanes. But it is less busy, which is nice. So up to you if you just give me a couple of months that you're thinking. You think you guys want to go in the winter time? It's a perfect time to go, I agree. How about February? Great. February is a great month to go. And what sort of travelers are you guys? Do you guys like to see nature, do relaxing activities, go on really exciting adventures, go to expensive and luxurious restaurants? You could also say a little bit of both. I can incorporate a little bit of each type of experience into your visit. A little bit of both. It's always nice to get a nice variety of what Jurassic World has to offer. So we're gonna have some adventure, some viewing of nature, which includes our dinosaurs, and some very exciting experiences. Through this book here, and we can pick out some of your favorite dinosaurs we can be sure to make sure that you experience on your visit, okay? So let's take a look. So I have to preface this by saying we do not have the entire catalog of dinosaurs yet to the park, but our scientists are constantly going out and covering new fossils to develop and synthesize new and exciting dinosaur genomes to release into the park. I will say that we currently have Dimorphodon, is a pterosaur. All of these you see here are our flying dinosaurs. Most of them are also pescivores, which means that they primarily eat fish. contact list. Like those dimorphodonts, yes, they're quite cute. I have a long beak on them. No, we don't have any of these huge dimorphodonts. Not yet, at least. You can see some of the marine dinosaurs. We are currently in development of the plesiosaurus. See here. These dinosaurs tend to have these very long necks. They lived in oceans, and just like a lot of the pterodons, they liked to eat fish. Legendary Loch Ness Monster, which is a plesiosaur, if he's out there. And we can probably get you into the prehistoric aquarium while you're at the park. You'll get the chance to see an ichthyosaurus such as this on the bottom here. See this dolphin-like dinosaur. Every single first-time visitor, I like to set up a showing of the massive Mosasaurus, 50-foot-long dinosaur, one of the largest marine dinosaurs to ever have lived. Absolutely gigantic creature. You could see some of the classifications of different dinosaurs here. Theropods, sauropods, those long neck land dinosaurs. See a Loasaurus. right here. We have these lovely dinosaurs in one of our cohabitation herbivore exhibits. Most famous of the ceratopsians being the triceratops, of course. Here it is. Three-horned face. Triceratops. Of course, a lot of these herbivores we keep in cohabitation exhibits. We tend to find that these creatures feel more secure around other herbivores. We are currently in development of iguanodon and dryosaurus for a new exhibit, which will be open by the time you visit. Parasaurolophus might be familiar for you. A long crest coming out of the back of the head. It's very, very iconic. Dinosaurs. Another one of the dinosaurs you'll be able to see. Of the stegosaurids, most famous stegosaurus, but also the wyongosaurus found in China. We don't have chontrosaurus, but might be familiar to you. And of course, we have Ankylosaurus. Really fantastic dinosaur to see. They're very often getting into battles with each other. You'll probably be able to win this when you're there. You like the sauropods? Yes. They're hard not to like. Tall, long-necked dinosaurs. The Brachiosaurus, of course. Some of your favorites. Well, that's perfect. I have just the thing for you. Thank you. Yeah, the apatosaurus. Very long, massive dinosaur. We do our own types of building dinosaurs at Jurassic World. You'll be able to see fossils. We have a lot of fossil information. I'm going to show you how we actually extract the DNA from the fossils to create these dinosaurs. Now for everybody's favorite types of dinosaurs, the theropods, the top predators of the time. Types of raptors. We don't have the Coelurosaurus, but we do have the Coelophysis, as you can see here. 10-foot-long dinosaur ate lizards and fish, so it didn't go for any of the more larger game dinosaurs. Something that we've been working on developing for a little bit of time now. Haven't quite nailed the genome down quite yet, but we're in the process. But the baryonyx, smaller but similar dinosaur. Doesn't have that same beautiful comb on its back, but has that specialized snout as well for catching fish. Allosaurus, yes, another quite famous meat eater at the time. Tyrannosaurus, and yes, we do have two fantastic Tyrannosaurus Rexes. Absolutely a top predator. Cannot put them in exhibits with other dinosaurs. It just doesn't work. But you will see quite a bit of Compsognathus around the park. They're a little bit like weeds. Once we put them in one exhibit, we find them in another exhibit, and in another exhibit. They tend to get along with pretty much everybody, because they're tiny, and they like to hang out in little packs, and they just eat small little critters. So even in some of the herbivore exhibits, you may see some meat feeders there, and that is for the compsognathus that like to hang out with our herbivores. I believe when you come, the gallimimus will be in development, ready for release a little bit later after your visit. Have these quite bird-like dinosaurs yet, but as I said, we're kind of constant development. Our scientists are out and about digging up new fossils all the time, and of course one of our most famous and proud exhibits is our pack of velociraptors. Healthy and happy pack. You're going to just love to watch their interactions. I think we have a good idea of the sorts of dinosaurs that you're into. So let me put my computer back and we can get to some planning. Alright, so we can start by getting your flight booked. Now, which airport will you be leaving from? Okay, let me just do a little bit of a search here. I see, they get you on a non-stop flight. Looks like it's about 5 hours long. So we can book that one. And it's a great price, so it's gonna fit perfectly into your budget. Okay, so we're going in February, so we got that set. I think we can do February 22nd to the 28th. That works. It looks like the flight is pretty early in the morning at 3:10 a.m. It's early, but you'll have that full first day ahead of you, and I can really book in some fun things on that first day. It's gonna be a long day, but we'll accommodate that for the next day. Okay, perfect. And then return flight. We'll do it for the afternoon. Looks like 3 p.m. to 8:15 p.m. back home. So it's a long travel day. You're going to fly into San Jose International Airport in Costa Rica. And from there, you'll jump on a small light aircraft to the coast, the Pacific Ocean coast. And then from there, you'll board an Airbus helicopter, very comfortable, to make the trip to Isla Nublar. Yeah, so it's three flights there and then three flights back. But once you arrive to the airport in Costa Rica, we're going to have someone there to meet you and take you to the plane you need to go to, so you don't have to worry at all. Once you arrive in San Jose, someone will be there for you to take care of you. And with that set, we can set up your package. Keeping into account all of those things, the dinosaurs and what you're looking for in this trip, I think we can put you in the Sauropod Hotel the first day. And yes, we can get you into the Hammond Creation Lab tour. That's a standard thing we like to do with all the new visitors. Show you how these dinosaurs are made. And I see in February, we have Dilophosaurus, Campsognathus, and the Gallimimus, like I said earlier, that are going to be in development. The Campsognathus, we always have those going because they get a little bit lonely when the pack size is too small. Alright, then we'll keep it easy for the first night. But day two, I see we can do a first gyrosphere tour. Maybe even make it a full carnivore day where you get to see a lot of our carnivore exhibits. Okay. And day three, maybe we can do a marine-based day. Get a chance to go to the lagoon zone, see the Mosasaurus, see the Plesiosaurus, visit the prehistoric aquarium, do a nice small group dinner, private dinner at the prehistoric aquarium. Okay. Day four, what should we do? We can do another gyrosphere tour. We have a couple of different gyrosphere tracks throughout Jurassic World. Some for herbivores, two for herbivores, and then one for the carnivore exhibits. We can do favorite ones. Okay. Alright, could get you on that one. Then for your fifth day, we need to get you into the aviary area, so maybe we could do that on day five. Aviary hatchery tour. Dinner in the Dimorphodon viewing gallery. See, spaces are available there. Right. And you really want to do something very adventurous, let me see if they have any openings in February for a ride along. Yes, they do. That's perfect. So I can book you in for one of our mobile vet units ride along. Looks like they're going to be doing some vitamin shots and immunizations that day. So you'll be able to ride along with one of our paleomedical facility personnel. That is going to be amazing. And since you're going in February, the weather is going to be beautiful. And usually we only cancel those sorts of things for bad weather. Okay, so that's going to be an awesome last day for you guys, okay? Alright, so let me just get this all together here. I'm just gonna get this printed out and put it in a nice brochure for you, and also scan your passports and give them back, okay? So let me just get that going. This all set up. So let me give you back your passports. Here you go. Alright, so let's get this all organized together and I'll show you everything that you need to know for your trip, okay? So let's do that. I've printed out your entire itinerary, and also I'll be giving you this map of Costa Rica. You could sort of see where you're going to be flying into, where you're going to be flying to along the coast, and where you'll be getting on that helicopter. Isla Nublar is just on the edge of this map, the full map. So you'll be able to see the distance and where you're headed. So we'll include this brochure here. Let get this. Organized in here first. So including a packing list. It's never a problem if you forget something, though. There's a lot of convenience stores on the island. Some of the frequently asked questions. There's a lot of questions that you might have though, so if there's ever anything that comes up, you can contact us at any time. Either by calling the Jurassic World toll-free number, or sending Jurassic World an email, or sending me an email, whatever you decide. I was also able to get you first class on your flight. No extra charge for the first class. Since it is a very early flight to Costa Rica, I want you to be as comfortable as possible. Then these pages are itineraries for each day. Along with information about what to expect. I've planned in some downtime for you, where you can either relax or explore the rest of Jurassic World at your leisure. There's a lot of attractions to see beyond the ones that I've booked you into. So now I think we can go through all of these pages and I can show you all the information just in case you have any questions about it, okay? So, why don't we take a look? Right, so first of all, I got you this brochure. I'm gonna put this in here. There's a map in here of the whole island and the whole park. It's gonna be very helpful. Some information about attractions that I have you booked into. And of course, important advice to make sure to wear your armband at all times, and you'll receive that at the visitor center on your first day. It's important because that'll give you complete access to the monorail, which is included in your park admission, and that's unlimited monorail rides, so I suggest you take complete advantage of. Also, the Costa Rica map, I will put this in here as well. Okay. So, it's a 6-night, 6-day adventure to Jurassic World. As I said, here is a detailed packing list. Medications, glasses, contacts, make sure you bring sunscreen, make sure you bring any vitamins that you are used to taking, backpack, raincoat, just in case. You also need to bring a dress outfit because your hotel dinner has a dress code, so keep that in mind. This is a little bit of information about our hotels. We have 3 hotels. All of them feature a unique dinosaur experience. Your particular hotel, the sauropod, is going to have a sauropod feeding at every single dinner time. And it's a 5-course gourmet meal every night if you decide to join. Not required, but always an option for you. And we are also coming out with a underwater hotel coming in 2024, so stay tuned for that. And of course, here are some of the most frequently asked questions. Questions about the park's safety, emergency procedures if there happens to be a containment breach. We have not had any visitor deaths since our opening, so keep that in mind. And will excursions be canceled due to weather? Typically everything is rain or shine, with the exception of capture team, ranger team, and paleo medical ride-along. Those, if there's bad weather, then those do not proceed with guests. And then also about personal medical emergencies. There is a medical facility 24/7 on the island, and there's also multiple nurses stations throughout the island which can transport you to the medical facility. If somehow you cannot be treated at the medical facility, you will be airlifted to Costa Rica mainland for treatment. And those helicopters are ready to go at any time. So, you need not worry about anything. So, here's some information about the arrival. I already explained that to you. And your particular flight information is right here. And then we have your everyday's itinerary. Your first day when you arrive is going to feature a welcome brunch at the visitor center with a presentation. There you'll be checked in and get your scan band. Then you will proceed to the Hammond Creation Lab in the afternoon to have a tour and see how our scientists create all of our fantastic dinosaurs. And for dinner that night, I have you at your hotel enjoying the wonderful sauropod feeding of the evening. The next morning, you will proceed to go on a carnivorous gyrosphere tour. You'll get to see a wonderful selection of our carnivore dinosaurs, theropods, baryonyx. Very, very exciting. You're gonna love this tour. Our gyrospheres enable a 360-degree view out, so be able to see all the dinosaurs from all angles. After that, you'll go to the Velociraptor Viewing Gallery to have a lunch and watch the velociraptors during your lunch. And for dinner time, it's up to you what you'd like to do. You have a free evening on day two, so you can explore the park, go see attractions, or go to dinner wherever you wish. We have tons of fantastic restaurants around the park. Day three is going to be the marine excursions at the lagoon. You'll start the morning with a breakfast and a show at the Mosasaur Lagoon Viewing Gallery. It's underwater, so you'll be underwater and you'll get to watch Mosasaur feeding and swimming, and you'll get to see the absolute sheer scale of this animal. It is incredible. And after breakfast, you'll have a free afternoon to go through the underwater walkway of the lagoon and see all of our lagoon marine animals, marine dinosaurs. And then for dinner, I have you at a private dinner at the prehistoric aquarium. It's not going to be entirely private to your party only. There'll be a few other parties in attendance, but it'll be a wonderful, intimate evening at the aquarium where you can walk around and see all of these wonderful, wonderful prehistoric fish and dolphin-like dinosaurs. So your day four is going to be a little bit more of a free day. You can start your breakfast how you wish. I highly recommend the continental breakfast at your hotel. They always do a fantastic job of putting out a very fresh spread of bakery and fresh fruit, a lot of fresh tropical fruit. And in the afternoon, you're free to explore the park as you wish. Go to attractions you've seen, go to attractions you haven't seen, whatever your heart's desire. And then, in the evening, you will go on an herbivorous gyrosphere tour at night. So, we have fantastic state-of-the-art night vision goggles you will wear in your gyrosphere to watch these herbivores' interactions and movements at night. We find that herbivore dinosaurs are similar to herbivore animals. They don't tend to sleep a lot, as much as carnivorous creatures. So, you'll see many of them up and about, walking around, feeding, interacting with one another. So it is a really, really awesome tour. On day five, we're doing all of the aviary things. You'll start your morning light after the nighttime gyrosphere tour, and then in the afternoon you'll go to the aviary hatchery to have a tour. we hatch our aviary and flying dinosaurs in a different hatchery than the Hammond Creation Lab. So we'll be able to see the unique process that is involved with these dinosaurs. And then for dinner, you'll have a seafood delight dinner at the Dimorphodon viewing gallery. And we have vegan and vegetarian seafood options there as well. Delicious, delicious offerings. Your last day is probably the most exciting day of your trip. You'll start your morning by having a tour of our paleomedical facility. That's where any injured dinosaurs are treated, as well as we develop new medicines and new vaccines for our dinosaurs. And then in the afternoon, you will go on a ride along in one of our mobile vet units, MVUs. And this day, they're giving out vitamin shots and immunizations to some herbivorous dinosaurs. So you will go right up into the exhibit, up close and personal. And our veterinary technicians are very personable, very informative too. You're gonna have such a fantastic time. And then for your last evening in Jurassic World, I'm giving you a free evening to hit up any sites that you're missing, or whatever you wish to do that evening, get it in before you leave the next day. Okay. Okay, so this is going to go with you. And as I said, if you have any questions, email me or give me a call and I can sort anything out for you. And if you would like to change anything in your itinerary, just contact me three months before your leaving date and we can make changes that you wish. Okay? Have a fantastic trip to Jurassic World.